Exclusive from the I-Team tonight. The state legislative auditor is expected to produce in the next couple of weeks his findings in a detailed probe of St. Bernard Parish government.
The report will focus on matters involving former Clerk of Court Lena Torres and issues first raised by the WDSU I-Team nearly 1 year ago now. Investigative reporter Travers Mackle live for us at 6 with what state auditors have been digging into. Travers?
Camille, the probe by state auditors started a year ago this month, and though they can't speak about the report just yet, both Lena Torres and her son, Chalmette lawyer Sidney Torres III, tell us they're prepared to respond to some very detailed concerns.
Driving down Judge Perez Highway in St. Bernard Parish, you can't miss the signs. The office of attorney Sidney Torres is open for business. A longtime lawyer in the area, Torres is expected to be a key figure in a soon-to-be-released legislative audit that centers on how his mother, former Clerk of Court Lena Torres, ran her office. The state auditor spent weeks in St. Bernard Parish examining the office since being contacted by the Metropolitan Crime Commission and Rafael Goyeneche.
About allegations that there were some problems in the St. Bernard Clerk's office under the Lena Torres administration.
The allegations Goyeneche reported to the legislative auditor include a claim that Sidney Torres III was not paying the parish mandated fee of $300 when he filed lawsuits.
The allegations were that attorneys were paying those, with the exception of Ms. Torres's son, Sidney Torres III.
The I-Team has learned that the initial findings support Goyeneche's claims and involve hundreds of lawsuits filed in the parish. If confirmed by the auditor, that would amount to more than $100,000 in unpaid fees. It's likely that auditors we'll use that basis to establish whether Sidney Torres III was given preferential treatment by his mother. The legislative auditor does not carry law enforcement powers, but can refer findings to investigative agencies such as the state's attorney general or local prosecutors. It would be up to them to determine if any laws were broken.
Under the legislative auditor's rules, if they believe that there is the potential for a criminal violation, then they have a responsibility to make a referral.
The I-Team has confirmed that Sidney Torres III and his mother each received copies of the legislative audit last month. Torres' attorney says his client offered a lengthy response refuting many of the findings. But the allegations of possible violations don't stop there. Last fall, the I-Team reported on concerns regarding the shredding of documents during the transition period at the St. Bernard Parish Clerk of Court's office. Incoming clerk Randy Nunez told WDSU then he was concerned that Lena Torres or others in her office failed to adhere to protocols regarding the destruction of records. That matter, the I-Team has learned, will also be addressed by the audit. Goyeneche says if the auditor confirmed problems related to the shredding of public records, he expects further action.
Particularly if there is an intent to obstruct an investigation or to injure public records. So those are the types of legal calls that need to be made by a prosecutorial agency.
Once again, this report is expected to be released in the next couple of weeks. In separate statements sent to the I-Team today, Lena Torres and Sidney Torres III both note that they're barred by law from speaking about an audit prior to its release date. They said they would address the findings once the audit is officially made public. Norman and Camille.
All right, Travers, with that update, thank you so much for that investigative report. And we should also add to that Lena Torres started working in the clerk's office in 1940 and was elected as clerk in 1988. She succeeded her late husband, who held the same office for more than 20 years. Neither Lena Torres nor Sidney Torres III has been charged with any crime.